Another case that we had was here. It was where it was a two-year-old boy who was beaten to death. That one was really hard. It was more difficult because the defendant had a prior case, actually, of a CHIPS case, because he beat this little boy previously to the point where he was in the ICU for, I think, 6 days. The defendant got out on bail and went back and beat this little boy again to the point where he was lifeless. And you hear a lot of motions, a lot of stuff before a trial. You know the allegations because we could see the complaint. You know, it's all public. It's out there. You read articles in the newspaper about some of these incidents. So you know what the story is. You know what the offense is. But when you actually start to see the evidence part of it in trial, I think that's what makes it hard. Like, you hear it, you can process it, but until you see it for me, that's when it becomes difficult. We had, in that case, the emergency room nurse on the stand who broke down crying. And I think that got to me so much because she sees tons of stuff on a daily basis. And for her, and this was probably a year after the incident, for her to actually struggle to maintain her composure on the stand, it was just heartbreaking because you just, and then you saw the photos and you heard, they basically made it sound like this little boy would have been like in a car crash going 60 miles an hour without a seatbelt on. That's how much damage was done to him.